Three, two. That's a two. That's a two. Two, one.
Oh, you're not supposed to say the last two.
Action. We're recording. Do something record worthy.
Oh, my name is Ryan Thomason, and it is 65 degrees in Philadelphia, and I hear it's really cold in a lot of other places.
Fuck you. It's 19 in Seattle this morning. Anyway, I'm Brian West, and we got a fun show for you guys today. We have some ninja news. We got a ton of stuff we're going to cover, especially some Star Wars news. We're going to talk about why Ryan is yet to see Rogue One. What a loser.
It's a very good explanation.
We got Justice League. There's a new Justice League photo we're going to dive all into and ask the question, why does the Flash have crotch armor?
Yes, and we also got the GDR Trailer Park. We got one really terrible movie, and another meh. And then we got Brian getting utterly crushed in the GDR cover to NFL segment, which we might have to end soon. So just, yeah, you know, like a mercy killing.
Well, we're going to end it anyway because the end of the season's coming up. But we also have Faithful 50, questions from all you guys. And, of course, the do or do not, our weekly recommendations this week. So stick around for the show, people. It's going to be goddamn fantastic.
You will be entertained. Sorry. Blah.
Are you not entertained? I feel like I need two swords and a loincloth. I'm going to be yelling. Anyway, whatever. Let's see here. This is the part where we pause it. There's going to be some cool jangle that I'm going to make at some point in post-edit. Yeah! All right, cue. You know what? You guys are going to see all this because I'm not going to fucking edit any of this shit. It's going to all go up on the interwebs.
You know, that's just how we want it. So, I don't see any problem with that.
Well, for two reasons. One, because we're fucking lazy. And two, because that's how we goddamn roll on this show, Ryan. Because we are paid unprofessionals.
Yes. And we don't have time for fancy shit yet.
Yeah, well.
We will once we learn how to do it.
Ooh, which I'm currently doing. I'm in the studio every day working on my beautiful MacBook. Anyway, nobody wants to hear about my MacBook. What people want to hear about is, welcome to episode 85. This many. I'm sure that gag gets old for everybody else, but never for me. 85 of the Geek Dad Report. The one show dedicated, formulated, specially created into talking about why goddamn Ryan has not seen goddamn Rogue One yet.
Do you want the sad version?
Yes, there will be questions that need to be answered. Oh, Pat. And hopefully entertaining the shit out of you while we bring you the news that was this last week, kind of behind us. I don't know, time? A while ago? Flashpoint. The news that was brought to you by Flashpoint, and hopefully making you smile just a little bit. Just a smidge. Because 2017 is already better than 2018, 16, unless you count that goddamn inauguration. And I'm saying goddamn a lot tonight. I don't know why. Yeah. That gosh darn inauguration that's coming up in a week. Fuck that shit.
And I'm not even going to watch it, honestly. I'm going to add zero to the ratings of it.
Good, because nothing irritates our soon-to-be president more than low ratings, because he's the best with his tiny hands. But this is not the Utah Outcast or any other political show. This is the Geek Dad Report. So we're going to talk about awesome nerd shit that happened this week. And there was a lot of it. After, 3 weeks of, nothing, we got all news today.
The ninja news literally just, exploded ninjas everywhere.
Yeah, this was have you seen that? Have you seen the Wolverine? The only cool scene in the Wolverine when, all the ninjas jump out to get Logan? That's what happened with our ninja news. Literally me and you. I'm clearly Logan, and you're the Japanese girl with the sword. But we were on our way to save somebody, and fucking ninjas jumped out everywhere.
Yes.
So I'm going to sacrifice myself because I'm an immortal, and I'm going to let you run away and save yourself, Ryan.
That doesn't sound very fun from my end of this.
Well,
you get the cool, I don't think this is a 50-50 split, is what I'm trying to say.
It's not.
Since when? We have a contract, Brian.
Anyway, on that note, since you haven't seen Rogue One, Ryan, I've decided to bring back until you have seen Rogue One. I know this is a complete change of subject, but I don't give a shit. I'm the host, and I will direct this fucking shit show any direction I want.
You're only half a host, good sir.
I am the 51% host. You know what? I upload the show, so I am 51% host. Anyway, we have had viewers point out that Ryan, it entertains them that Ryan has not seen Rogue One yet. And so until Ryan does, we are bringing back Star Wars trivia. Ryan, who was in charge of Echo Base on Hoth? I will give you four choices, and you will guess wrong, but I will give you two anyway. Number one, General Rakeen. B, General Veers. C, General Dodonna. And D, General Mills. I can guarantee, I can confirm that one of those is an Imperial, so do not guess that one. What is the answer, Ryan? You have 5 seconds.
B.
God damn it, that was the Imperial, you son of a bitch. No, the correct answer was General Rakeen. You are the worst at this game. You're the absolute worst. God. You know who's disappointed? I'm disappointed. You have failed me for the last time, Ryan.
That's not even how he sounds. At least I know that.
Look at the girth of my lightsaber. Look how big it is and red and shiny. Wait a minute, you're over here. Ryan.
I see you, Schwartz. It's as big as mine.
Look at this. Hey, Ryan. I got something for you.
Is this the Schwartz? Are we going Spaceballs on this now? Or?
Whatever, man. I can't even talk to you right now. You're the worst.
Hey, I'll admit, I do not have a very encyclopedic knowledge of the Star Wars universe. I like to watch the movies. I did not pay attention to names
so,
very well.
Just so you know, General Veers is the leader of the AT-AT squadron that bombards.
Well, now I know.
Hoth. There you go. Where's that dude? Where's that little fucking unicorn sparkly star that flies around?
The star.
And it gives that stupid chime that everybody knows that I can't all of a sudden say. Whatever. Anyway, you know, we're not going to talk about your deficiencies in the Star Wars universe. But I want you to know that you need to be ready, like a ninja, like Ninja News, because I have, look at that, I got a stack of them.
Oh, God.
We're going to get through all of them.
Maybe this is going to happen every week until I see it.
Yes. Look, I got a whole box.
Trivia
box, Ryan. I'm going to give you an easy one. Who's this guy?
This is...
Hang on, let me put this...
Very embarrassing.
Guess who it is. All right, moving on. For all you iTunes listeners, sorry, I was shaming Ryan with an action figure of Darth Vader.
It's all right.
All right, Ryan.
I can take it.
That's what I heard about you. Oh, hey. Shit. Anyway, all right, moving on. Lots of ninja news. We are not going to have a feature tonight because we have so much ninja news, so you have to deal with it, people. What the hell? You got a Rancor over there? You know what a Rancor is? No, it's your microphone. Don't hang up on the show.
Alright. Push the cord back.
Alright, we're good. You ready? Are you good?
Yes.
Need a moment? Are you composed?
Well,
I talked a lot. I'll take a drink. Go ahead.
I'll do the Cobra Kai's leg sweep of knowledge just to get my ninja news kind of.
Alright, well then I'm going to throw in the uppercut of information, Ryan. And the judo chop of straight fucking awesomeness.
Because I took knowledge from you, and I knew that I was going to screw you up.
I forgot which one you usually do, but I feel like I feel like I recovered very well.
You did.
All right, boom. First story, since we're talking Star Wars news, and I got this goddamn lightsaber in my hand, is going to be Star Wars stuff.
Really?
Yeah. Put that away real quick, and before I ask give you the first information, Ryan, who exclaimed. Oh, this is really relevant. This was actually... I did not plan this. Who exclaimed, "Into the garbage chute, flyboy"? I'm not even going to give you the four choices.
That's Leia.
Princess Leia. Ding, ding, ding. You are correct. Speaking of Princess Leia, she's in our news. She's our top news story because you know what? We always give the princess the top news story whenever possible. I don't know. Which one should we do first? We'll do the first. We'll do the sad one first. Well, kind of sad, but super awesome. So, Princess Leia, Carrie Fisher, just recently had her private funeral with her family. And someone released a picture of the funeral and had everybody going like, is that what I think it is? Oh my God, that's amazing. So, apparently Carrie Fisher decided, because this is how awesome she is, that when she died, she would be cremated and her ashes would be put into an urn. A special urn that she had created for this. It was the urn, if you have not seen the picture, you have got to check it out, is a giant Prozac pill. And it's about this big, and it is a Prozac pill.
It looks like her brother's holding, like, a baby Prozac pill.
It's half green, half white, has all the RX numbers on it, and it's awesome. Anybody who doesn't know why that's cool, that was her drug not of choice, but of necessity to fight. I think she was bipolar, and she had a few other things that she was fighting in her life, so.
She had severe bipolar, like, really, really highs and like really, really lows. So
and she Prozac was her friend in life, and so she decided that she needed to be cremated and stuck in a giant Prozac pill, which honestly brings everyone's death game. Like, she has raised the bar. I figured, like, just do with me what you will, but now I feel like I have to come up with something awesome.
My body's dead. Like, I'm dead.
I'm putting you in a giant glass dildo, Ryan.
Just quarter me up and spread me to the four corners of the country.
I'm gonna get a giant dildo urn and I'm just gonna carry it around with me and hit people with it. Right. Yeah, I'll do that for you because you're my bestie.
You can put me in a giant film canister of Rogue One because I hadn't seen it yet. Then I'll always be there.
You know what? We just did a trivia. You're lucky. I'm not going to do another one. We haven't even got to the second story yet. All right. Also, some more Carrie Fisher news is apparently BBC is being reported that they are in the Disney is in negotiation with the Carrie Fisher estate. Apparently, they would like the rights to use her in digitally recreate her for future Star Wars films. So, we talked last week, what does this mean? What is the future of Princess Leia? And then we knew that this week they were all meeting to figure out what they were going to do going forward. My guess is, with the success of a movie that Ryan hasn't seen and some of the brought-back-to-life people in that movie, that they have decided that they are going to move forward with the original storyline of Princess Leia, and they need to digitally recreate her, which I think is a mistake if that is true.
Well, I'm willing to bet that she was probably a massive part of the ninth movie. That is my guess. And that they don't want to have to change the whole storyline, so they want to try and use it where they can.
They'll just recreate it from this movie.
That's just my guess.
Well, it is also possible that they're not...
But she's just too much a part of it. Like, they can't. They're like, this is going to fuck everything up.
Well, I will say this. I know you have not seen Rogue One, but unfortunately, we're going to have to talk about it just a tiny bit here. I won't try and give too much away, but Tarkin is in this movie a lot more than you think, and they recreate him digitally, and they do a pretty good job of it. And so my guess is that they know now they can do it, so there's also a possibility that maybe they don't just move forward with the original storyline, that they do have some new scenes they have to shoot and they have to do to make it make sense. So it's possible that they are, you know, they need permission so they can recreate her for those scenes to help the story go forward. So it may not be much. Maybe we get 5 minutes of screen time total with a digitally recreated Leia, where maybe we were going to get 20 minutes of screen time with her in episode 9. So I don't think this is going to be a complete recreation, but it definitely seems like they want permission to be able to use her digitally in movies.
Not a good idea.
I think done in moderation, it'll be a good idea, and you'll see why when you see the movie. But
moderation and like faraway shots.
You have not seen Rogue One yet, so we can't really talk about this, Ryan.
Just do a trivia, make yourself feel better.
Hey, Ryan.
What?
I want to tell you a joke.
What?
Go knock, on. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Force.
Force who?
Did you see me force choke all those people in my new movie? Ha ha ha. Oh, wait, you didn't. Because you're a loser.
No.
I'm going to go to my castle now.
That's probably gonna go hang out with drunk Harrison Ford.
Dude, do not talk. Do not say his name. He's like Beetlejuice. You say his name three times, he shows up drunk on the show.
Well, there's one.
What did Owen Lars tell Luke Skywalker his father had been? A Jedi Knight, a Sith Lord, a navigator on a space freighter, or a fighter pilot?
A fighter pilot.
You are wrong.
Was it the space freighter navigator?
He was a navigator on a space freighter.
I was going to say that. But then I was like, fighter pilot sounds kind of cool.
You are the worst. All right, moving on. We have lots more Disney Star Wars news to talk about here. So, a lot of Episode 8 news. Well, not really a lot, but Episode 8 is... We're going to get a trailer, probably. Rumor is it's going to be with the Beauty and the Beast movie. I'm going to say that it is, but they're going to do a worldwide release. Big, huge, like... Probably during the Super Bowl is my guess. We're going to see the first teaser for Episode 8. But...
Wouldn't surprise me, honestly.
But that being said... Rogue One's success has been huge. It's kind of winding down, so now they're moving on to Episode 8, and the Episode 8 machine is going to get just getting started, and people are starting to give a little bit of interviews and a little bit of tidbit details of Episode 8, which we are all dying to see. At least I know I am dying to see. But the first bit of news came from director Rian Johnson himself. He was interviewed by USA Today, and he gave five interesting facts about Episode 8. So we are going to talk about those. These are not really spoilerific, but if you want to know absolutely, positively zero before going into this, which is going to be impossible unless you live in a bubble, because there's going to literally be a trailer on every 30 seconds for 6 months on TV.
You guys have no idea how hard it has been to avoid Rogue One spoilers.
Really. Oh, well, you're not going to avoid them tonight. I'm going to tell all of them.
Oh, that's fine. I can tune you out easily.
No, you cannot. No one can tune me out. This is my special X-Men power.
Everyone listens to you no matter what.
Yeah, they have to. They have to soak in all my knowledge right into their freaking eye sockets. But anyway, these are not spoilerific, but you have been warned that we're going to talk a little bit about the movie. So the first little bit of detail that Rian Johnson came is everyone's been speculating what the title of this one's going to be. Apparently, it has a title. It's had a title since the original script and has not deviated from it. So all these different information little dumps that you've seen on the web where it's talking about, this is going to be the title, this is going to be the title, all wrong. The title has been set in stone since day one, and we're going to be hearing about it really soon. I have no idea what it is. It's probably going to be like Episode 8, The Force is Still Awakening.
Episode 8, The Search for More Merchandise.
That's a good one. Episode 8, Luke's back, motherfucker. Luke has lines.
Episode 8, now less Trump.
Episode 8, right after The Force Awakens. That's what it's going to be called. Because apparently the second thing we learned about this is that it takes place literally right after The Force Awakens. There will be no time jump.
It's going to be her handing the lightsaber, if that's where it's going to start.
I really hope they open it. Like, that moment was so dramatic. I hope they... hope they open it with, like, a joke where he's kind of plays off with Yoda and he just looks all serious, but then he's like, oh, hey, you found my lightsaber! And he runs over and gets it. Or uses the Force to grab it over, and he's like, man, I've been missing that thing, and then just, like, walks off.
That was my son's biggest gripe about Episode 7. Like, she's holding the thing out for Luke. And I was like, you know, that's the first time my son probably seen Mark Hamill since... because he'd never seen him, like, on anything else. And so he's, like, right when that's over, he, like, turns, he's like, what?
I know.
Why?
Well, he was not the only one disappointed. I was very disappointed that that's all we got of Luke Skywalker. He was my favorite character in Star Wars growing up. And I kept waiting for him to show up in this movie, but I'm very excited about it. So apparently, a little side note here, I was listening to Nerdist yesterday, and they just recently aired an episode with Mark Hamill.
Oh, it was so good.
I know. He's scheduled on our show. He's coming soon. Can't give a date yet. But he'll be on the Geek Dad Report. You heard it here first.
Ooh, yes.
As soon as I get a new Mark Hamill action figure. But one of the things that he had said is apparently he didn't know either that he is only going to have one scene in the movie until the reading took place. They told him to get ready. Apparently he trained for 50. He trained for an entire year getting ready for that movie. And then he's the best shape of his life. He was great. And so he's like, I trained for 50 weeks for get back into shape for Luke Skywalker.
He grew the beard.
He says he shows up to the table read and he keeps waiting. He's like, apparently he was like me, because I kept waiting for him to show up in that finale with Ren and right when Han, you know, I kept waiting for him to show up on Starkiller Base. And apparently he was reading it, and he was thinking the same thing at the table read. He keeps waiting for his character, and then at the very end, he's like, are you kidding me? You guys had me train for an entire year, and this is what I get? And then he's like, you know, and he goes, and the worst part is they put me in all these Jedi robes. He goes, I could have taken the whole year off from training. Nobody would have known how fat I was. You know, spoken like a true, 60-year-old man? 50s, early 60s? Yeah, so spoke like a 30-year-old man. I wouldn't want to do that either.
God, he looks good for his age.
Yeah, well, you know, thank God he's still around. I couldn't handle losing any more of our Star Wars legends.
Oh, yes. Especially Luke. I think that would be, the hardest one. But let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Okay, so, speaking of Luke, a couple of the other things we learned about episode 8 is that Luke and Rey have a very strong relationship in this movie, and that there will be even more of the familiar tones, the family theme going into this. So take that as you want. If you think that Rey is a Skywalker, like I think she might be, or at least some connection with Skywalkers. Well, I think she's either Kenobi or Skywalker. I've heard some people say that they hope that she's just a nobody. I don't. I want her to be. I like everything being connected.
Can't the midichlorians make Jesus force babies?
Listen, those rapists are just running around impregnating people left and right, so yes, they could have easily made. I had a theory that Rey is actually the reincarnation of Anakin Skywalker. We'll see if that pans out. But we will talk more about our theories about episode 8 after I see a trailer and way over speculate and nerd out hard on the show. In fact, we're going to do a live trailer reaction on this show when they release episode 8, because if you want to see me tear up and then be like, yeah, we'll do that. Also, another thing about Luke, the fourth thing we learned about this is that Luke is exactly what the fans want him to be in this movie, which means he's going to be awesome.
Like grabbing Star Destroyers and smash.
Oh my god. I have heard a rumor, and I'll take this as you may, this is a little spoiler, but it is a rumor, so I don't know if it's true or not, but I've heard that the Knights of Ren eventually confront Rey and Luke on Ahch-To at some point, and that Luke doesn't even use a lightsaber, he just uses the Force to explode things. Yes.
Okay, that's true. That's
take my money. Bad. Take all my money. I'm gonna buy the whole theater out for 3 screenings straight and just sit there and just in my underwear, just spooge fest watching Star Wars 8.
But Finn's going to train to be a Jedi too, right?
Well, no, Finn is not strong with the Force. But we will, but point five is that in this movie, we're going to continue to learn more about not only Luke, and we're going to find out where he's been. Well, we know where he's been, but why he left and his, you know, kind of his motivations. We're also going to learn a lot more about Finn and Poe and also Kylo, and kind of apparently this movie dives into his humanity and has you see the choices that he's making and the strife and the internal conflict that he has. So, you know, I don't know. He killed Han Solo. Fuck him. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah.
What a dick.
Killed Chewie's best friend.
I wish Chewie shot him in the chest. But I am glad they didn't Darth Maul his ass. That would have been terrible.
Yeah. At least they didn't, cut him in half. And
I mean, he is a Skywalker after all. So is Rey. Maybe. Probably not. But who knows. Let's see. Moving on. What else do we know? We know that there's official. I just cracked myself up. You guys have no reason why. We know that Star Wars has its first official Woody. Harrelson.
It's a big Woody too.
It's a big Woody. Yeah, I don't know. It's an old Woody.
Some would say the best Woody.
It's a bald Woody. Alright, that's enough dick jokes.
This is the type of Woody that you can just take out and polish every now and then.
I don't know where you're going. Did somebody say polish? Would you like to polish my helmet, Ryan?
No, I don't.
You could polish it while we're watching Rogue One together. Did I tell you I'm in the movie? I will get you special tickets.
I heard it was very brief.
To the loser section. I'm out of here.
I heard it was very brief. Anyways.
Who said that about me? It was long and awesome.
But regardless,
it was very forceful.
Woody Harrison's going to be Han Solo's mentor. What do you think about
you
that, baby?
You can feel your throat constricting right now. Alright, fuck you, I'm out. Yeah, what we were talking about with all the poorly used Woody jokes is that Woody Harrelson has officially been cast, I think we talked about it last week, in the Han Solo standalone movie as Han Solo's mentor.
Which is, I think, a good casting choice. I mean, Woody Harrelson seems like he'd be a good smuggler.
Oh, he'd be a great smuggler. And he was a good mentor in the Hunger Games.
He was good on Zombieland, too.
Yeah, he was good in Zombieland. He's also, you know what else he's good in? White Man Can't Jump. Now, that's a classic.
Wesley Snipes.
He lost so much money trying to dunk. Just let it go, dude. Let it go. You're never going to beat Wesley. That motherfucker was Blade. You're not going to win. Anyway,
God, I totally forgot about that movie.
Yeah. Any speculation on what he's going to play? Anybody you think? I heard a couple cool ideas.
For Woody?
Yeah.
I think he's going to play a CGI. He's going to have some kind of alien.
Oh, you think they're going to CGI him up? I don't think so. I think he'll play a humanoid. So, here's what I think. I think they could be bringing... This may mean nothing to you, because I don't know how much of the expanded universe you read or played the games, but Dash Rendar, who was in a lot of the Star Wars games early on, I think he could be making a comeback. They've been doing a good job of bringing the expanded universe characters back, you know, like Rebels and stuff like that. This would be a good place to bring one of them in. Or Evil Chris from Utah, our friend over at Utah, brought the idea that he could be playing Sir or Lor San Tekka. I don't know his name. Basically, he was the character played by Christopher. Was it Christopher Plummer? Yeah, Christopher Plummer in The Force Awakens, the old guy who dies at the very beginning, who gave Poe the information.
Oh, that guy.
That guy. Which, if that was true, that'd be kind of ironic. So, if he started out as a smuggler who became, you know, a Force follower, how ironic is it that he trained Han, who had a kid who eventually kills him later in life?
Yeah, that's kind of a vicious cycle. Honestly.
I think that it should totally happen then. Lor San Tekka. There you go, guys. I said it right. I could not, in good conscience, carry on without have saying the name properly. Just like in good conscience, we can't carry on unless Ryan can answer this question. We get a new question. You wanna got that one. I want to give you a fighting chance.
Okay.
Who asked, who is the fool? Who is more the foolish? The fool or the fool who follows him?
The fool who follows him.
No. Oh, God. Ryan, you're the worst. No, who said it? Who is more the foolish? The fool or the fool that follows him?
Oh, who said that?
Who said that?
Do we get multiple choice?
Oh, no! Oh, how do you not know this? I'll give you a hint. It's from A New Hope.
Is it? It's, was it Obi-Wan that said that?
Yes, it was Obi-Wan. That is something a Jedi would say.
Yeah, it took me a second to think about it.
You're the worst. All right, moving on.
I got it right.
You know what? If Alan was watching this, he'd just be cringe. He'd just see, like, nails on a chalkboard. Like,
you know, Alan is a very nice person.
He is a very nice person. Lucky for you.
I'm sure he would find some very nice person ways to thrash me.
Probably. Well, I guess we should probably give Alan... hi, Alan, if you're listening.
Yeah, you listen.
Those of you who don't know Alan, he's our good friend who writes with us and hangs out with us occasionally, and is also the host at Idiotsery, a great Star Wars podcast over at, I think, makingstarwars.net. So check him out if you really want to nerd out on Star Wars like I do every other Thursday.
Yeah, and I should never go on that podcast. But moving on.
I'm going to go on that podcast. I'm gonna browbeat Alan into having me on one day. It's going to happen. I might be too nerdy. I might be too excitable for the Force. All right, moving on. Speaking of the Force, George Lucas has a big Force of a $1.5 billion, and he's slapped that fucking right on the city of L.A. You know what he did? You know what that is?
Disney money.
What?
Just making it rain. That's what he's doing.
And George Lucas showed up in the middle of L.A. and just with bags of cash threw them up in the air, and they are going to turn into a giant George Lucas museum.
No, I thought it was a Star Wars museum.
I don't think it's a Star Wars museum. I actually think it's a Lucasfilm museum. It's going to have... I know it's going to have a ton of Star Wars stuff. I'll be honest, I did not dive into everything I've been hearing. I listened to a couple Star Wars podcasts, and apparently this was something that was trying to get pushed in Chicago, and the powers that be in the city of Chicago kind of pushed back, and it didn't happen. But I know it's going to have a ton of Star Wars stuff, but I think it's a Lucasfilms. I don't think it's necessarily just... So, I mean, that means it could have some Indiana Jones, some Willow, anything that has Lucas attached to it.
So basically he's just paying $1.5 billion to have, like, a big circle jerk to himself.
I mean, shit, we're going. I'm putting that on the Geek Dad Report credit card. Are you kidding me?
So that's something that you'd invest in to... Here's the Brian West Museum.
Well, if I had that... Dude, he got $4 billion from Disney. What's he supposed to do with it? I'd build a museum to myself, too.
And he probably still gets, like, residuals or something,
dude,
you know.
Ryan, you're talking to the wrong guy. I am so narcissistic. If I got $100,000, I'd build a statue of myself in my front yard. Much less $4 billion. Are you kidding me? Of course I'd build
I can make a 200-foot statue.
Ryan, if we got $4 billion for the Geek Dad Report, we would spend $1 billion on the Geek Dad Report Museum. It would be amazing. It would rival the Hall of Fame, the base of the Cooperstown Hall of Fame. It'd be amazing. Anyway, let's not talk about how awesome we are. Let's continue with the news, since we still have a lot of it to go through. Last little bit of not really Star Wars news, but because it has Mark Hamill, it's kind of Star Wars news. Mark Hamill, I don't know if you guys saw it. We don't usually get too political on the show, but we did want to just say that you should watch this because it's hilarious. Mark Hamill decided to make a video of the Joker, the animated Batman animated Joker with a puppet talking. And he read all of Donald Trump's tweets as the Joker. It is one of the funniest things you will ever watch, I guarantee it.
Yes, and it's exactly what you think it's going to be.
Glorious.
Awesome.
Glorious. That's it. Just watch it. We put it up on our Facebook page, or you can check it somewhere else. Just Google Mark Hamill Joker Trump, and it will show up. It is amazing. And kudos, you know, Mark Hamill. You are amazing. Can't wait to have you on the show.
You know what else is glorious, Brian?
Which actor played Wedge Antilles? Dennis Lawson, Jack Purvis, Garrick Hagen, or Phil Brown?
What was the question again?
Which actor played Wedge Antilles?
Oh, which actor?
Yes.
Okay. I don't know. B.
Wrong again. Dennis Lawson. A. There's actually two actors that technically played Wedge. I would accept either one, but you got both wrong, so congratulations. You are one for, like, 27.
You know what George R. R. Martin killed other than my... passion for Star Wars.
Every character on Game of Thrones.
he's now saying that Winds of Winter is going to be done this year. Possibly. Maybe.
I think the actual quote was, somebody asked him, is Winds of Winter going to be done this year? And he said, yes, the plan is to have Winds of Winter done this year. But the plan was also to have it done last year. He's such a fucker.
He is.
I'm literally going to be caught up on the Game of Thrones books before he releases the next one. It's going to happen. And I'm reading them really slowly.
HBO will be doing his prequel series.
Oh, we talked about that a couple shows ago. Yes, I'm on board. We got to wait until May, Ryan. We got 5 months still. Well, 4.5 before we get to see more Game of Thrones.
Because they had to wait till winter to start filming. So
whatever. They had to stretch it out to get to go for 3 more years for 2 seasons. What a bunch of jerks. Whatever. You know who else?
By watching some Charmed on CW.
Do you remember the name of the sisters were?
No, I never watched that show.
I watched it a few times. It was dumb. I watched Buffy. Buffy was a way cooler version of Charmed. Let's be honest.
It was one of those shows that was always on, like, at 6 o'clock in the morning, and my dad was always watching it. Because my dad gets up, like, super early.
My sister was living with me at the time when Charm was on, and she loved it. So, I mean, I caught a few episodes when she had it on, just watching in the background. But it just was never... And I like geek shows. I just was not a Charmed fan. But the reason why I bring up Charmed is because CW is apparently rebooting Charmed, but kind of with a twist. Apparently this one's going to be set in 1976, so technically it's not a reboot. It's a prequel-ish?
I don't know. Sounds dumb.
I don't know. Whatever. I mean, I'm not going to knock CW because they give us a lot of things that we love, so go ahead, I guess. But I will not be watching Charmed.
Yeah, well, at least CW's rebooting the whole Arrowverse.
No, they're not rebooting. They renewed.
Or not rebooting, yeah. They're renewing it.
You gave everyone a heart attack.
Yes, I gave everyone a heart attack. No!
Not the reboot!
Not again.
No, Ryan is correct. CW has renewed all of its comic book shows. That means Supergirl, Arrow, Flash, Legends of Tomorrow. Actually, I can't say all because iZombie has not been renewed yet. And technically, that is a comic book show. And the 100 has not been renewed yet either. But Supernatural, not a comic book show, renewed for its 13th season. It's amazing. The Winchesters will never die. Well, they've died like 8 times.
I feel bad that I got so far behind in that show that I never took the time to try and get caught up. But now it seems like it's going to take like 2 years.
I can tell you which seasons to skip. But it's such a great show. I love Supernatural. It's a fun show. Dude, this year, they brought back Hitler, and Dean killed Hitler. And for like 2 episodes, he kept telling everybody, hey, guess what? I killed Hitler. So great. It's a great episode. But, hey, whatever. We're all cool. We're all happy that
I'm surprised Legend of Tomorrow is coming back. I thought that one was probably the closest one to be on the chopping.
Here's the deal. I think the ratings have slipped a little bit on that, but I do think they need that to do the four episode crossover. And I think it's gotten better this season than it was season one. I just think it hasn't quite found its audience. But I think with them constantly adding new members to the Legends of Tomorrow, they'll find they'll find the sweet spot, and eventually it'll become a good show for them. But I will say that a lot of media outlets had me really angry because the headline all read, CW picks up Constantine, and I was like, yes! Yes, but apparently they have picked up Constantine as a CW seed show. So it's if you're not familiar with that, it's a 10-minute like animated shorts that they do. They did one for Vixen, which I haven't watched. You know, I should, but they do take place inside of the Arrowverse universe. But I have not watched them, but I will be watching these Constantine ones. They are going to be voiced by Matt Ryan.
Where do you watch that at? Is it going to be?
I don't know. I think it's online. I think it's at CW.com or probably through their app. So what I got to check it out. I'll look into it and I'll let everybody know.
If they do a crossover and they put all of them on the animated show for a part of the crossover.
That would be awesome. I'm going to watch it. I have heard the Vixen. I've been told I need to check out the seasons of Vixen. It's actually a really good show. I will definitely be watching it because I love Constantine. I love Matt Smith or Matt Ryan's Constantine. It's such a good character. I want to talk more about it, but we do have a little bit of somebody asked us in the Faithful 50 a little bit about Constantine, so we'll answer. We'll kind of talk more about that in that section. Let's see here. Let's blow through a bunch of this stuff because we got a couple things we're talking about.
All the Fox shit.
Fox. So apparently, no surprise, Fox is really close to picking up X-Files for yet another season. Everybody wants to do one. They did the six-episode season earlier this year. Everybody was everyone loved it. Everyone was glad it came back. You know, the episodes were kind of hit and miss, but who cares? We all love Fox and Mulder, and it was cool to see him, or Fox and Scully. It was cool to see him back, but sounds like that Fox definitely wants to do it. It's going to happen in 2018, and it's not going to be the 6 episodes, but it'll be less than 22. So my guess would be it's probably going to be a 13-episode season, which is fine. I think that's probably the sweet spot for X-Files at this point anyway.
Yeah. I watched the first episode, and I just haven't gotten to the rest of them.
Yeah. Well, watch them all. They're fun. Avengers Infinity Wars is picking up. The movie, I believe, comes out next year, so they're starting to get everybody together, the cast, and they're going to start shooting here later this year. Some rumors are finally starting to come out about it, and some more characters have been confirmed. There's, like, what we say there's going to be, like, 82 characters in this movie. Spider-Man has officially been confirmed for Infinity Wars, which we're not really surprised.
Yeah.
Marvel has their new toy, their new favorite toy back, and they're definitely going to be using them as much as possible. But one surprise casting that surprise rumor is that apparently Liv Tyler may be coming back and reprising her role as Betty Ross, Hulk's love interest from The Incredible Hulk. So I think that'd be pretty cool. She's one of the characters that I really enjoyed from that movie, and a lot of people forget that The Incredible Hulk is actually part of the Marvel, the MCU.
Yeah, okay, so that's actually part of the... Okay.
Yep. It has Tony Stark in the post-credits, and they brought Thunderbolt Ross into Civil War, so it's part of it.
Yeah.
Kind of loosely, but it'd be cool. I know a lot of people would... She's one of the more favorite female characters that they have not brought back into the MCU, and I'm sure a lot of people are excited about it. I am. I like Liv Tyler's Betty Ross, although she was great. But no confirmation yet. That's kind of just a rumor that's floating around, so we'll see. All the Guardians of the Galaxy has been confirmed, and also apparently Peter Dinklage is in talks right now with Marvel to star as a pivotal character in the movie. A lot of people are rumoring that he's going to play MODOK, which... I don't think so. I don't think you're bringing Dinklage to play MODOK.
Which, so everyone knows, you spell that with a K.
At the end of it? The end. Is that M-O-D-O-C?
I wrote it right the first time.
If you don't know what we're talking about, Ryan misspelled it on the Facebook page and got thoroughly thrashed by a few people for it.
Yeah.
Bad nerd. So, bad.
I'm a terrible nerd.
Sounds like the type of person, Ryan.
I don't even know why I'm on this show anymore.
The type of person who write that, it sounds like the type of person who wouldn't go see Rogue One. I'm staring at you with my evil stare.
There's plenty of people that have not seen Rogue One yet, just so you know. Just saying.
Yes, but do people know what Han Solo, what Luke Skywalker said to Han Solo, that the Han Solo was best at when Han refused to help. What did Luke Skywalker say Han Solo was best at when Han refused to help at the Battle of the Death Star?
Running?
Taking care of himself, Ryan.
Yeah, something like that.
God, the worst. All right, moving on. Let's see here. We'll save our Justice League news for last. Golden Globes, we're not going to talk about them because nobody we wanted to win won except Zootopia won, but whatever.
Yeah. Big whoop.
Deadpool is the one that we wanted to win. It won nothing. But you know what? The writers of Deadpool 2 have been talking to Collider, and apparently the information they gave means we all win because Colossus, Negasonic Teenage Warhead, and Dopinder, the taxicab driver, will all be back for Deadpool 2. Ugh, that is fantastic news.
Yeah, Teenage Warhead was probably the one character that I thought was probably more fun just because I didn't really know anything about her.
She was great, and her powers were awesome.
Yeah, and it's just, you're going to keep texting? All right, we'll wait.
Hey, Fox, I'm going to throw something out there. When you have people who actually give a shit about the X-Men and care about mutants and want to just make a good movie, you can have cool characters that nobody even has ever heard of, and everybody loves them.
Yeah.
Fox.
So good. And Colossus is all fighting that chick.
Screw you, Fox. Except for Deadpool. Screw you. I'm excited for Logan, though. We'll see. I'm sure I'll be let down, but I'm excited right now.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
All right, and lastly, we have a bunch of Justice League news for you guys. And we'll try to keep this to 7 minutes, I think is what we're doing. Yeah, all right, 6 minutes now. So Justice League released a cool photo that has all the members of the Justice League minus Superman. Well, all the members that we know about in the Justice League right now. It was a cool picture. It had basically a Batman and his new tactical armor, Wonder Woman, Cyborg, and Flash and Aquaman all in their decked out gear. And they looked pretty badass, honestly.
Yeah, and, I didn't know... Like, the one thing that we have been talking about, though, is why the fuck Does the Flash have crotch armor?
So, yeah. So if you know what Ryan's talking about, the first time I saw the picture,
I mean, not that I was just like,
No. I pointed this out immediately. I looked at it. Yeah. I totally did. I looked at the picture. I zoomed in. You know, first time I saw it, I was at work. I was on my phone. I'm looking at it. I zoom in. You know, it's a high def picture, so you get all the details. I zoom in. And the first thing you notice is that Batman is goddamn huge. Like, you're like, oh my god, this Batman.
He's like shoulders.
This is like the chest. This is the Arkham Asylum, Arkham Knight Batman. I mean, he's just. I mean, you knew he was big in the last movie, but man, when you put him next to everybody, he's just like this. He's a tank, right? And then, but he looks great. Gal Gadot, she is Wonder Woman to me. I love her as Wonder Woman, but she looks a little stoned, as our faithful 50-minute Jeff pointed out. She looks a little like. And then you go to Cyborg. This is kind of the first look we got at Cyborg, and his, you know, with his cybernetics and CGI'd body for the most part, it looks pretty cool. Yeah. Aquaman looks great. First time we've seen Jason Momoa in his full-on Aquaman gear with his trident. He also looks like a tank. He's huge. He's just ripped. He looks awesome. Yeah,
but and then you get the Flash. Same. You know,
who looks cool. Now, I feel bad for Flash because we have the CW show. And it's so good. His costume's so good that you get this one. And the fact that Flash has all this armor just kind of looks goofy. But then you scroll in, accidentally land on his genital area, and you notice that he has a piece.
He has
a piece of dick armor right above his crotch, and it's just floating there by itself. And you're like, "Why the hell does Flash have a piece of dick armor? I mean, Jesus, why?"
Well,
he's faster than a speeding bullet. No one's gonna shoot him in the balls.
Batman might.
Batman would try, and Flash would run around in circles. He's literally faster than the speed of light.
So, what if...
Damn you, Zack Snyder. Of all the times I defended you, why did you have to give Flash dick armor? Seriously.
Maybe just if he's running and there's a low pole, and he tries to hurl it,
doesn't get high enough. Apparently that's why they give him dick armor. Too much friction. I don't know. I just personally, I think it looks a little goofy. I would have not gone that direction. I think the unisuit, kind of the way that they have Grant Gustin's costume, I think would have worked great for Ezra Miller. I just can't get over Flash's armor looks goofy.
I know. Just don't feel bad that you copied the one from the CW. It's a good fucking suit.
It's great.
You don't need to.
It's from the comics.
Yeah.
You want to give everybody else armor? You want to give Superman, like, textured suits? That's cool, man. I love everybody's look, but I'm just not a big fan of the Flash. And when you look in his entire costume, it just kind of looks goofy. I'm sure it'll be great in the movie, and I'm still really excited for it. But
It seems like it's like there's that one producer guy who's like, you know, I think the Flash needs, you know, some big armor pieces.
To be fair, they probably had like a onesie suit, and then with everybody else's armored out look, he probably looked just ridiculous, and they had to.
And his
look is very much off the video games Injustice. Flash has kind of an armored suit. It very much looks like that. I just don't know why you don't give him a full like crotch area armor. Why do you got to give him one floating? Yeah, it's not even that big of a piece of armor. So if I were Ezra, I'd be like, yeah, make that way bigger. That needs to be the biggest piece of armor on my costume.
It needs to just be flopping around.
It's got to be like a 10-inch piece of armor. Just bow right there on the Flash joke.
The Flash.
I
may be quick in a lot of things.
I know you were staring at the cod piece.
There's one thing that the Flash takes his time on.
The cod piece. Booyah. Anyway, I don't know. Let us know what you think. That was our thoughts on that. Other than that, I don't give a shit about the haters. I'm really excited for this movie.
I just don't want it to have to get an Ultimate Edition
Yes, Warner Brothers. If it's a 4-hour movie, just release it as a 4-hour movie. I'll go twice. I'll go three times. Maybe even five. Ryan will wait 7 months to see it and then talk about how awesome it is.
Yeah, I'll see it like right before it leaves the theaters.
He will see it when it's $1.52. on base.
Right before it hits the red box.
Right before it hits HBO. Go. Anyway, another movie we're both really excited for, Wonder Woman. Their promotional stuff starting to ramp up. It comes out in July. It has been announced that, a little bit of a spoiler, not really, but a little bit. So you've been warned. The villain for Wonder Woman has been confirmed to be Ares, which, no surprise there. The God of War fits in perfectly to the, you know, the Greek drama.
She's going to get the helmet.
Yes, hopefully better. Fucking better have the helmet. That's all I'm saying. If Flash has a goddamn cockpiece armor, then Ares gets a helmet. That's all I'm saying. That's got to happen. But they have released a bunch of new pictures from Wonder Woman. They all look great. The movie looks good. Hopefully it is good, but it looks fantastic. So I'm excited.
Me too. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. Another thing we're looking forward to, Ryan, is the Green Lantern movie. At least I know I am, because, fuck it, I look forward to all comic book movies. And apparently we finally have some details on the new Green Lantern movie that's coming out, I believe, in 2020.
Ooh.
Yes, it has been announced that the writers are David Gower, something, and Justin Rhodes. And if that name sounds familiar, it's because he wrote Blade, Blade 2, Blade 3, and Man of Steel. And I believe Dark Knight. He helped Christopher Nolan. So yeah, so David Gower has been, he was kind of the go-to guy for comic book movies for a long time, but he is going to be spearheading this whole thing as far as the writing goes on the Green Lantern movie. I don't know who this Justin Rhodes character is who is writing with him, but, you know, whatever.
And don't forget, DC is doing Justice League Dark animated movie.
Yes, I believe we will be reviewing that on the show.
So, I'm just starting to get emails about it, so...
Yes, and we will be doing a full review of that rated R animated, I'm guessing, going to be Jim. It's voiced by Matt Ryan. It's going to be amazing, and I'm not talking about that shitty quarterback from Atlanta that the Seahawks are going to fuck up this weekend. So anyway, last little bit on Green Lantern. It's also going to be, it is confirmed, it's going to be a Hal Jordan, John Stewart buddy cop movie. Apparently, they're billing it as a Lethal Weapon in Space movie. Eh. Whatever, I'm in. And that's all we got. There you go. Congratulations. You guys survived 40 minutes of news.
Ooh.
Super awesome ninja news. And now we have two shitty trailers that we're literally going to spend 1 minute on. And the Geek Dad Report Trailer Park. Ding, 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 ding. First up is the new Chips trailer dropped yesterday based on the Chips TV series starring...
Those Michael two Pena guys.
And Dax Shepard. I'll just gonna save everyone the trouble. That trailer sucked ass. Hopefully the movie is better because the trailer was terrible.
It looks like it's a crap-a-crap-tastic kind of review, honestly.
What I don't get is a lot of people are like, it's hilarious. No, it's not. It's terrible. And I normally enjoy dick jokes, but when half the trailer is a dick joke, and then they throw out like, oh my god, are you homophobic? No, I'm not. It's not funny.
Yeah, it's...
If you're going to throw out a dick joke, you can't joke about being homophobic at the same time. You just got to throw out the dick joke and just be cool with it.
It seems like they're doing for dick jokes like that one... What was the Adam Sandler movie that we reviewed?
Which one?
They had the pegging in it. Like, it was just like constant.
I thought that was funny. The Do-Over?
Yeah, that's right.
That movie,
the Getaway or something.
It was terrible, but it was funny.
That movie was terrible.
Yeah, I know, it was bad. When your first trailer has literally, what, four or five dick jokes?
Yeah, come on, man, you're trying. Dick touching, and...
Yeah, I enjoy a good dick joke. I just didn't find these ones funny. I just didn't thought that. I don't know. If you saw it and you were totally... think we're way off base, I would love to hear what we're missing out on, but I just did not find this trailer funny. And it's not because it's a reboot or a remake. I thought the Baywatch trailer looked hilarious.
I had my clicker on the X just waiting for the thing.
Dude, it was painful. It was only 2 minutes, and it felt like 20. The movie's going to be awful. But anyway, that's just what I think. Tell us what you think. We'd love to hear it. The second trailer we saw this week was for Cars 3. Disney released the first full-length, and it was a minute-and-a-half trailer for that. I thought it looked good. I mean, it was definitely feels like a Days of Thunder kind of reboot, which is fitting for a movie about car racers.
Yeah, it's pretty much what you were going to be expecting from the third Cars movie. I think.
It definitely looks better than the Cars being spies second car movies. Looks like that it's was kind so of terrible. Gotten back to. Yeah, I didn't think it was awful. I just didn't think it was good. It's This one definitely seems like it's going back to its Cars 1 route, which was a much better movie. But,
yeah, I mean, you can tell they're going back to the actual racing stuff and all that, and hopefully less Mater, and more just like what made the good first Cars movie good. Wow, we'll see. I know my kids are gonna want to see it, so I'll have to see it regardless.
Whatever. It's one of those things. It's not really moving the needle, but hey, you know what? After watching Chips, it was a vast improvement. I'll tell you that.
Yeah, don't watch Chips first. So watch the Cars movie first, and then that might change your opinion. So.
Yeah. Now's your chance to change my opinion on if you know Star Wars trivia or not, Ryan. What was Luke Skywalker referring to when he said, "What a piece of junk"?
The Millennium Falcon.
Oh my God! If you got that wrong, we might end the show today. It'd be the last episode. Welcome to the 85th and final episode of the Geek Dad Report. Ryan's been fired and the show's been collapsed. All right, moving on. Way to go, Ryan. Way to go. Way to redeem yourself on that one. You got that one. I was a little worried for a second.
I had my moment.
So let's see. What's our next segment? From the Faithful 50, because we don't need to talk about the Geek Dad Report cover 2.
No. We got to do the cover 2, my favorite part.
All right, so we'll spend very little time on this because it's a one-sided ass-whooping. I'll give you a hint on who got their ass-whooped.
In this week's
NFL picks.
So with our totals right now as we stand,
Brian
has selected 53 games correctly, 38 wrong. Not bad.
That's terrible.
Not too bad, you know. But here you were up at one point by like 12.
Okay. Get to it.
I now have 63 points and 29 losses. So I'm a full 10 points up on you.
Well, Super Bowl's worth 100, so we'll be fine.
Yeah, so Super Bowl is worth 100 points just because, you know, we're kind of at the point where it's like a mercy killing, or I could just kind of let you hang in there. So I'll be nice.
I'm going to double down. Yeah. Just wait. I'm going to get all of them this weekend. All
right. So
what are the games this weekend? The show's only four of them.
Four games.
Seahawks. Winners.
Falcons versus Seahawks. You're picking.
Seahawks. Because they're the best team ever.
I'm going with the Falcons.
Of course you
are. I'm going to try and get some separation going here. Because we did pick a lot of the same teams.
You know what? That's our plus 10-point game of the week. Plus 10 points right there. Boom. Plus 10. I'm doubling down.
Well, what do I get out of it?
Nothing. Because you're going to lose. You picked the Falcons. You get 10 points if you win.
Oh, okay.
All right, let's go to the next crappy game. Who are the Steelers going to lose to this week?
Texans versus the Patriots.
Oh, God, Patriots. Not even close. Should we bet on the points, Brent? I'm going to say the Patriots are going to win by 21.
God. If it's anything less than 21, it's going to be a disappointment, honestly.
God, all right. I think the point spread's 15 in the NFL. That's insane. Osweiler's going to throw 7 interceptions. They win. I'm going to laugh when Houston wins. We're all just shocked.
Savage is going to come back in and
throw for 7 touchdowns.
Yeah.
All right.
So we have the Packers at the Cowboys. This is going to be a good one.
I don't know who to pick in this one, to tell you the truth. And I can't even go with my heart because part of me, of course I want to see the Packers win because I think I'm going to win. So I would love to see the NFC Championship in Seattle. But I don't know if I'm going to play Aaron Rodgers right now. That guy sold his goddamn soul to the devil for Hail Mary touchdowns. I'm not really sure what he did. You know what? I'm going to go with the home team. I'm going to say Dallas is going to win this in a close, close game.
I'm going with the Packers. Like you said, Aaron Rodgers is on fire right now. I'm not saying this because it's my wife's team and I'm contractually obligated in my marriage.
Jordy Nelson, 2 broken ribs, not going to play.
Yeah, but they still got Adams, they still got Janice, they got a lot of wide receivers. I mean, they got Montgomery if they really need to put him in there. So I don't know. I think the Packers, this is going to be the game to watch, though. I mean,
the game to watch is gonna be the first game of the year, Falcons Seahawks
for Sunday is what I meant to say. But the other game to watch will be the Steelers versus the Chiefs. My pick is obviously going to be for the Steelers.
I'm going to take the Chiefs, and not because I hate the Steelers. Honestly, Big Ben plays terrible in cold weather outdoor games. It's going to be freezing cold in Kansas City. And I think that Kansas City is going to grind this one out. They always do this. They show up, they play one game really good, and then they lose to the Patriots. So I'm going to say it's Kansas City. I think it's going to be a close one, but Big Ben was in a walking boot, which means he's going to throw for 500 yards and 7 touchdowns out of his wheelchair.
Yeah.
God, that guy's such a wuss. What a prima donna.
I think Le'Veon Bell is going to continue what he's been doing, and he's just going to show his patience and bust out some big-ass runs.
Let's just say that it would not surprise me if the Steelers won, but I'm going to go with Kansas City on this one, so there we go. And all games in the second round are worth 2 points, so that way I can somehow find a way to close my lead.
This is the first time we've gone so many games where we didn't pick the same team.
There we go.
Something's going to happen.
We only picked, one game the same?
Yep. We both picked the same.
Something's going to happen. I'm feeling something. Something's going to happen. You're going down is what's going to happen. Seahawks are winning the Super Bowl this year.
We all know that it was a mercy that even let you stay.
Mercy kill your ass. You better watch it. All right, moving on. From the Faithful 50.
We had some good ones this week.
Yes,
from our great friend. Except for Jeff. Jeff is the best. Don't you talk shit to Jeff. Let me say this.
Jeff makes the best memes.
I have known you since middle school. I always thought you were a cool guy. And then you put a picture.
Oh, no. Everyone's going to see the picture.
On our Facebook.
Real close, if you cannot see, look at that. It says, me waiting for Ryan to see Rogue One. It shows a guy alive and then dead. The best. Jeff, you get 2 gold stars for that one. I literally was driving and I saw that and I almost crashed because I was laughing so hard. It inspired the show tonight. Star Wars trivia, everyone can thank Jeff because Ryan can't answer questions like this. Who said, good against remotes is one thing, good against the living, that's something else.
Good against the what is one thing?
Good against remotes is one thing, good against the living, that's something else. Can you even tell me what movie it's from?
A Star Wars movie?
Han Solo said in A New Hope after Obi-Wan and Luke Skywalker were training. You're fucking fired. You're out. I am auditioning new hosts who know something about Star Wars. Anything.
I don't think you can't base.
If you can answer one question, who is Luke Skywalker? You're in. That's all you need to know. All right, moving on. So, first question of the night was from...
Star Wars isn't everything, Brian, just so you know.
You're fired. You're out. I don't know if I can fire you, but I just did. You're out. Brian from Washington wants to know, Have we kept any of our New Year's resolutions? And are there any hopes that Constantine will be coming back a live action Constantine show will be coming back now that CW has created the animated show?
Nope.
So I'm gonna answer the first one or the second one, Constantine. I do not think the show is coming back. Unfortunately, I think the show is dead. I do think with them bringing Matt Ryan back and kind of into the fold a little bit, I think there's a chance that he could end up on Legends of Tomorrow or become a recurring character on Arrow or Flash. So I would like to see him much more bigger part of the universe. So I think that's going to happen at some point.
Yeah. I think they're going to stick with the animated, and that's pretty much all we're going to get. So
Constantine?
Yeah.
Well, what do you know? You don't know anything, Ryan. Don't you shatter me and Brian's hopes, jerk. You're just a jerk today. You're the worst. All right. So as far as to your first one, I don't know, Ryan. News resolutions. We talked about them last week a little bit. Have you stuck with your resolutions so far this year?
I have stuck with my eating better and all that shit. And I have actually been working on the editing for one of my books, so...
Oh, nice. Good work.
Doing all right after, what, 2 weeks? So, haven't quit yet.
So, let's see. What was my New Year's resolution? I was going to try and live less on Facebook and just live in general. I feel like I've done a pretty good job of that. Yeah, we're going to talk about that in a second. I did post some pictures of me and my wife at the football game, but I thought that was just fun. I did not purposely, like, watch the game through my phone. I just took a couple quick pictures and threw them up there. So, I don't know. I guess that's kind of a wash. I think that's kind of a year-long thing. We'll have to see how I live vicariously through social media this year. But another one of my resolutions was to lose a little bit of weight. I'm currently down 3 pounds, so it's not nothing. And lastly, I want to grow my beard. So look at this. This is Beard Watch Week 3. Look at that. It's getting a little over there. You can see it.
It's actually getting dark.
Yeah, look at that. It's filling in. It's filling in nicely.
Look at you.
And by nicely, I mean very slowly. I'm the only man alive who can have a beard, but at a distance, you have no idea I have facial hair because it completely blends in with my face. It's like I'm like a lizard, right? I'm like a chameleon. I kind of just change color to my surroundings.
Yeah.
Whatever.
So, like, maybe you just need to get, like, some contrast going. So, like, get, like, an orange Donald Trump.
No. Don't
like,
ever say
face thing and then your beard will stick out.
Well, it's because
there.
The brown. Like, I got the yellow light and the brown background here. What I need is a black, complete black background. You know, I'm going to work on a studio in the garage here this year. That's another resolution. But, we will have our weekly Brian's beard update. There we go. It's growing.
Looking good.
It's getting there. I'll be a man. I'll be a man before I'm 40. I can feel it. Yes. All right, moving on. I'll be a real man one day.
Ooh.
All right, Jeff wanted to know how we felt about closed captions on TV. He says he finds himself using closed caption more and more these days when he watches, even though he can watch the show pretty loud. He just started watching The Crown on Netflix and it has some accents are pretty strong. It helps him hear things that he cannot understand. You know what's funny, Jeff, is I was actually just thinking about that the other day when I was watching something. I was like, you know, maybe I should turn the closed captions on because my hearing is getting terrible.
I see. As someone who has severe hearing loss, both my ears, I use closed captions all the time for when we're watching movies. It's part of the reason why it's hard for me to go to movie theaters is because I miss a lot of the conversations that are going because I'm spending so much time trying to focus on the screen. And so closed captions, God, I fucking love it. I can't really watch TV without it anymore just because I can still hear everything. But, I mean, like Jeff said, it's sometimes, like, if you're watching a lot of British shows, you have no idea what the fuck they're saying. Sometimes.
Well, the problem with those is sometimes the closed captions doesn't either, and they put the wrong words out there. I have not started turning closed captions on. Honestly, I kind of like the magic of watching. I like kind of watching something and getting lost inside it. And so whenever I start reading things, it kind of takes me out of the movie. So as long as I can get away with not having to use them, I just don't. But I can understand why people do, and it's probably something I'll start doing in the future.
Yeah. The only time closed captions really suck is when it's off. If it's off by, like, a second. You know, it's like
so
the scenes
like
are moved on, and it's like it says something on the bottom.
Let's see here. Jeff had one other question. It was on one of our other posts, but I was going to answer it on the Faithful 50. I just got to find it real quick. Do something entertaining, Ryan.
Jeff did mention that his new favorite part of the show is when Rogue One is brought up and Brian looks like a volcano about to blow.
Yeah,
because you don't want to spoil it for me.
Because I can't talk about it, Ryan. Because I can't talk about all the awesome that's in Rogue One because all you do is sit there and go, I see you. Watch my movie,
said...
Ryan. It's amazing.
I never said you couldn't talk about it. I just won't listen to you.
Well, great. That kind of ruins the show, doesn't it? All right, so I found Jeff's other question. So we had posted, I guess we might as well talk about it a little bit. They had, Entertainment Weekly has the first look at the Defenders for Netflix filming right now. And they had the cover for it. It looks pretty cool. It's got Luke Cage, Jessica Jones, Daredevil, Iron Fist, who we haven't seen yet, all together, ready to fuck shit up. And so anyway, Jeff's question was, he's watched Luke Cage, Daredevil, and he plans on watching Iron Fist and the Defenders. He wants to know if he needs to watch Jessica Jones. I'm going to say you don't have to. Me and Ryan did not love it as much as the entire world did, apparently. I will say this. The first 6 episodes are worth watching because Luke Cage is in them, and you get introduced to Luke Cage, and you kind of get introduced to him and Jessica Jones' relationship, even though it's kind of strange. I like that. And Purple Man, I'd say Jessica Jones is worth watching just because Purple Man is great, and so is Luke Cage. And there's some good supporting characters. I just am not enamored with it. So if you want to, do it. It's better than a lot of stuff out there, but it's not on the level as Luke Cage and Daredevil.
Jessica Jones is really good, like you said, for the villain. Because, God, now I can't even think of his name.
Man. David Tennant.
Yeah, David Tennant does an amazing job as the Purple Man. And that was honestly the best part of the whole show for me, really.
Yeah, it drags on. It should have been 8 episodes instead of 13, and there's about 4 too many episodes on this, 4 or 5, but I don't know. I would say watch it just because I guess it's worth it. It's better than a lot of stuff out there, but I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of it.
Yeah. If you got nothing else to do, go for it by all means.
Do I think you can watch The Defenders without seeing it? I do think there'll be some transitional stuff with Luke Cage and Jessica Jones that you may not quite understand, but I don't think it'll stop you from being able to enjoy The Defenders.
They'll speed right through that stuff.
Yeah, definitely. So, all right. So, moving on. Lastly, we'll blow through this pretty quick since I think both of our recommendations are not show and tell, they're just tell this week, is our Do or Do Not segment, what you should or shouldn't waste your time doing this week. Ryan? Would you like to go first?
I've been listening to a new podcast this week called 1A. It's a podcast. Actually, it's about the First Amendment. And it's a new episode every day.
Is that the one that says you can drink booze?
No.
Oh, okay.
There's some reporters on it. And they talk about the political stuff that's happening right now. It's just been a really good podcast. I just started it in the last 2 days, and I've just been downloading all of them to try and get caught up, because they're really good. It's very topical, very up-to-date on the news, and it's got actual reporters, and they actually talk to experts and opposites. Like, they talk to a Republican guy who was all about tearing down Obamacare and the ACA and stuff like that, and it's real informative. And if you're like us and you appreciate the First Amendment
or care about your government democracy at all,
yeah. So all right, it's so on 1A iTunes. On,
iTunes. 1A. 1A. All yep. right. Nice. I also this week have a podcast that I recommend everybody listen to. I recommend everybody check out Star Talk. It is the Neil deGrasse Tyson and Bill Nye the Science Guy. Well, it's Neil deGrasse Tyson's technically his podcast, but Bill Nye's on almost every episode. It's a great show, and it's not just about like the cosmos or really nerdy science stuff. I mean, they had a whole episode where they broke down the science of zombies and if the zombie apocalypse could actually happen, and they kind of make it relevant. They talk about The Walking Dead, and they interview the guy who wrote World War Z. I find myself constantly. What's great is they the whole last season you can download. It's like 100 episodes. I find myself every day just listening to it, and it's really cool because I feel like I'm back in school. I'm literally learning stuff every episode, and it's been a long time since I really learned things and felt excited about learning stuff that I already thought. You know, I there's things we take as truths that you don't know you're even wrong on, and it's been a lot of fun listening to those, and it's made me feel I forgot how much I love science, and when you listen to science and you listen to people who love science, it opens up. It's kind of opened up that childhood where I thought anything was possible and everything was amazing, and it's really it's actually really kind of lifted my spirits a lot and really made me excited for some stuff and really rethink about, you know, maybe I should start learning to do more things. And just because I'm an old curmudgeon now, my time on this earth isn't useless anymore. So it's been a really cool podcast. And even if you don't find as much as I did out of it, it's still really entertaining. It'll make you laugh. So check it out. Star Talk on iTunes, Stitcher, pretty much anywhere you can find those things.
It'll make you want to buy a telescope.
Yeah, and before we get out of here, Ryan, would you like to tell everybody where they can find us if they already don't know?
If you would like to find the Geek Dad Report, you can find us on Facebook at the Geek Dad Report, Twitter at the Geek Dad Report. You can find Brian at BrianWest53 on Twitter, and I am Big Bruiser. We are also on podhell.com, Watch Fire Read, and iTunes. So, and obviously, we have our YouTube channel. So, like, subscribe, leave us ratings, leave us comments, tweet at us, give us those thumbs up things on Facebook. Just communicate with us. We love talking to everyone. And if you just want to call or leave a comment saying Ryan's a big pile of shit, doesn't know anything about Star Wars, and he should.
You can say he doesn't know anything about Star Wars, but don't call him a big pile of shit. That's just mean.
All right. So don't call me that. But you can make fun of me about my Star Wars knowledge, because I don't give a shit. So, go for it.
Yeah, also, don't forget, a little after show note. As soon as we're done here, we're going to record a couple episodes of Comics You Crave. We have a little teaser for you guys. We have Flash Rebirth Volume 1 and Justice League Rebirth Volume 1 that we're going to be reviewing after the show. So those will be up on, I believe, Tuesday?
Yes, Tuesday.
Post those up. So check those out. Those are now going to be their own separate show on our network, on our Geek Dad network. So we're looking to expand and do some cool things, and that is the first step. Comics You Crave is going to be its own thing every week. But, you got anything else for anybody?
No, we're just stay tuned. We got, like you said, we're going to be doing not some DC comics, just because one of the creators of the comics has said they will come on for an interview.
Possibly.
So, possibly.
Yakuza,
too famous.
Demon Hunter. I'm really excited to read that. All right, stay tuned. And before we leave tonight, I'd like to ask one thing, Ryan.
What is
that?
Who
instructed Luke Skywalker to go to the Dagobah system?
Wait, say that again.
Who instructed Luke Skywalker to go to the Dagobah system?
Obi-Wan.
Boom! In on a high note. All right, everybody, thanks for joining us. Until next time, stay awesome, motherfuckers.
And nobody cares about Star Wars.
Fuck you. You're wrong. Oh, who said that? You can feel your life being extinguished right now. All too easy. Later.